Hello students, looking at current affairs for 20th May, the news items picked up from the Hindu newspaper are these 9. We look at them in detail. The first one, Health Ministry issues new guidelines for workforce. So Union Health Ministry has announced fresh guidelines on 19th May. So with the easing of the lockdown measures, now more offices and workplaces can start operations. So there are fresh guidelines which state that number one, anyone diagnosed or suspected or confirmed as a case of COVID-19 should immediately inform the office authorities and isolate themselves. And it is said there's no need for the entire office building to stop, close or halt work if one or two cases are detected. But yes, if there's a large outbreak, then the entire building should be shut down for 48 hours and disinfect. Then next is any staff requesting home quarantine based on containment zone activities in their residential areas should be permitted to work from home. Also, it would be mandatory to maintain physical distance of at least 1 meter at all times, along with use of face covers and masks. The minister also said, the Home Ministry said that there is no decision which has been taken yet to replace hydroxychloroquine, which has been introduced as a game changer to arrest the spread of COVID-19. It has been used as a prophylactic. What is a prophylactic? We have discussed earlier too. We'll see below too. It's a preventive medication. So, hydroxychloroquine's usage has been questioned by some experts, though it has proved beneficial in treating and, you know, arresting the spread of COVID-19. Even it has been used as a precautionary preventive medicine by healthcare workers, so that they themselves won't get infected by high-risk persons. It has been provided to avoid contracting COVID-19 or to stop it as such. So it has proved beneficial, but then there are other drugs which are also being used. So hydroxychloroquine basically is a treatment for malaria. It's an anti-malarial drug. So other combination drugs like HIV combination drugs can also be used, but they are quite costly. Hydroxychloroquine is quite cheap. It's very, very cheap. So the experts are demanding that HIV combination drugs should now be used, is what has been stated. But ICMR will take a final call on that. So that is there. And here you can see how the cases are increasing in the country. So, and the death rates as such too, from May 10 to May 19. So everyday cases reported are crossing, you can see here, 4,000 here, and now reach crossing 5,000. And the deaths as such. So you heard the axis here, y axis here shows the deaths. Then next is, Trump says he is taking hydroxychloroquine. So US President Donald Trump has said that he has been taking hydroxychloroquine for a couple of weeks to help ward off COVID-19 infection. So as we spoke about it, hydroxychloroquine is actually an anti-malarial drug. It is used for treatment of malaria, rheumatoid arthritis and lupus. So this is hydroxychloroquine. So it has been proven to be effective in COVID-19 prevention or treatment. But then it is said drug can have severe side effects including arrhythmia, which can be fatal. So this is cardiac arrhythmia. Basically, here there are electrical pathways which regulate the circulatory system. So this is how the normal heart functions. But here you can see in cardiac arrhythmia, atrial fibrillation impulses, haphazard impulses come up, which result in heart functioning being affected, which can prove to be fatal, can result in death. So that is one of the severe side effects which may happen. So that is being highlighted as such, but then it has been regularly used for malaria treatment and it is generally used without significant adverse effects. So it is the President Trump has said he is taking hydroxychloroquine and also is taking a zinc supplement and has taken single dose initially of even azithromycin, which is an antibiotic. So these are the treatments which have been used by various healthcare experts. US FDA has warned about hydroxychloroquine in April 2020. US Federal Drug Administration has said that it should not be taken outside a hospital setting or clinical trial due to heart rhythm problems, as we just discussed, which is arrhythmia. So this has been stated by US FDA, but President Trump says that he has been using it. Many healthcare workers have been using it and it has proved effective. He has done COVID-19 test quite many a times and has come negative. India is a major producer of hydroxychloroquine and we have sent shipments of the drug to US too. President Trump had asked India to lift the ban on drug exports and we have been exporting it too. So here you can see. So hydroxychloroquine is an interferon blocker and works by diminishing the immune system's response to the viral infection. So hyperactive response by the immune system is primarily responsible for pneumonia, which is a severe infection caused due to COVID-19. And it was a study in France that showed that hydroxychloroquine alone or in combination with azithromycin appears to reduce virus levels quicker. So many countries have approved the drug in restricted settings. But then, as we saw, there are adverse side effects like cardiac arrhythmia, liver damage, which may also happen. And Indian drug manufacturers say they have sufficient stockpiles and enough to export to. But there are reports also of stock running out for treatment of patients who require them to. Then next is India-US to collaborate on vaccine trials. So India and US plan to work together on vaccine research and testing for COVID-19. So, India and US already partners under Vaccine Action Program. And now they are planning to collaborate for vaccine research for COVID-19 too. So, this is a 33-year-old collaboration, you can see, between US National Institute of Health and Indian Department of Biotechnology and ICMR, along with other partners. Also, US has announced to provide, President Trump announced donation of 200 ventilators to India. Even US Center for Disease Control and Prevention, we had seen about this NGO earlier too, how it is under prior approval list for providing funding to India. It has also said that it would provide $3 million support to for prevention, preparedness and response activities in India for COVID-19. Then next is China tests drug that aims to stop pandemic SANS vaccine. So Chinese laboratory has been developing a drug it believes has the power to bring the coronavirus pandemic to a halt. So this has been tested by scientists at the prestigious Peking University, and it is said it not only shortens the recovery time for those infected but also offers short-term immunity from the virus. And what process they have they used? They have used neutralizing antibodies. So these are antibodies produced by human immune system. So that can prevent the virus infecting cells and also provide short-term immunity. So they have isolated these antibodies from blood of 60 recovered patients from COVID-19. They are using this technique to develop a treatment, a drug for COVID-19. Then next is reform or face fund cuts, Trump tells World Health Organization. So as World Health Organization Assembly, WHO Assembly, you can see we have seen it is chaired by India presently, World Health Assembly of the World Health Organization. It is meeting virtually to discuss COVID-19 pandemic. At this, US Trump now has said that World Health Organization should bring in reforms, major substantial reforms within the next 30 days. Because already USA has made temporary curbs in funding to World Health Organization, and it has been threatened by Trump now that it will be made permanent. Permanent cut in fundings, and even US may opt out of the organization, World Health Organization. So this temporary funding was stopped, funding was temporarily stopped in April 2020. So now it is threatened to be permanent, and this is why, because it wants substantial reforms. What are these? Basically, Trump says that only way forward for World Health Organization is to demonstrate independence from China. So Trump has criticized World Health Organization on its relationship with China, that it has not taken stringent measures against China for initiating or from where the COVID-19 began, the outbreak began. So here you can see this is the timeline shown here of COVID-19 outbreak, how the regions which have been affected have now shifted. First it was Eastern Asia, and now you can see it is North America which has the largest number of cases. Then next is state nod not necessary for Shramik trains. So, lakhs of migrant workers still continue to walk home amid the lockdown, and central government has announced now new guidelines, because Shramik specials, when they were announced, Shramik special trains on 1st May, the SOP, standard operating procedure, had said that these would run from point to point on the request of both the state governments, means the government from where the train begins, Shramik train special train begins, and the where it ends. So, that was the SOP of May 1. So, this provision has been dropped now, a new SOP on 19th May has been announced, in which it says that the scheduled destination and stoppage of Shramik special trains will be decided by Ministry of Railways based on request of state. So, only the state from where it commences, That state should register passengers and send a request, after which the train would run, and the consent of the state government where the train would terminate would not be necessary. So of course, this is going to create confusion, because states where the migrant workers would reach have to, that state has to provide for quarantine centers, transportation of the passengers from the railway station to their to facilities. So that would be a huge confusion which would emerge with this new SOP. But this is the SOP which has been issued, standard operating procedure. Then next is AP gas leak. Supreme Court declines to interfere with NGT order. So we had seen this was the gas leak which took place in Andhra Pradesh in Visakhapatnam region, and this was LG polymers. So this gas leak on May 7th resulted in National Green Tribunal taking suo motu cognizance of the event, and on May 8 it passed an order in which it asked LG Polymers to pay 50 crore as immediate interim compensation, and set the NGT also set up a 5-member fact-finding committee led by former High Court Judge Justice B. Sheshasayana Reddy. So this committee will inquire into the incident leading to death of several innocents. So this order of NGT has been challenged, and Supreme Court has been approached by LG Polymers, but Supreme Court 3-judge bench led by Justice UU Lalit did not budge, and it said it has to wait for the hearing. So multiple committees, the LG Polymers said, have been set up as such, including by Andhra Pradesh High Court, National Human Rights Commission, by the center into the gas leak. So it wanted NGT, National Green Tribunal, to not look into the matter. And Supreme Court looked into it, but Supreme Court did not interfere. So NGT, National Green Tribunal, you should know, is a specialized court which has been set up. It is also headed by judges, and it is set up to look into environment related cases. Then next is hotter oceans spawn super cyclones. So higher than normal temperatures in Bay of Bengal is said to be the reason which may be resulting in super cyclones. So this is in the context of super cyclone Amphan, which has developed in Bay of Bengal and is moving towards West Bengal now. So cyclones actually gain the energy from the heat and moisture generated from warm ocean surfaces. And because summer temperatures go high, then warming becomes higher and super cyclones are formed. So it's a reason for these super cyclones is said to be global warming from the fossil fuel emissions that have been heating up the oceans. Even cyclone Amphan, it has intensified from category 1 to category 5 in 18 hours, which is an unusually quick evolution. Last year in 2019, cyclone Fani was a category 4 cyclone which affected, which swept through Orissa coast and resulted in deaths as such too. And it was also because of high temperatures in Bay of Bengal. So tropical cyclones in Bay of Bengal are a typical feature of summer months, and they play a role even in the arrival of monsoons. But now, because of warming of the Bay of Bengal, and it's not just the Bay of Bengal warming, it is said it is also the Arabian Sea and the Indian Ocean which is warming up. So this makes storm predictions less reliable, as well as monsoon patterns may be disrupted. So that is it. There's another research which says that particulate matter emissions during the lockdown have been less, and because of less aerosols such as black carbon being formed, which are known to reflect sunlight and heat away from the surface, cyclones and ocean temperatures may be increasing. But this claim actually needs more research. Then next is criteria from medium units to be revised. So now the definition of micro, small and medium enterprises will be revised. This was announced by Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman when she was detailing out on the 20 lakh crore stimulus package, the Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan Yojana. So this Atmanirbhar Bharat Yojana had, in this, it had been announced that the definition would change, means expansion in the definition would take place. So the new definitions for micro, small and medium enterprises are provided here, you can see. So any firm with an investment up to 1 crore and turnover under 5 crores will be classified as micro, and up to 10 crores to 50 crores it will be small, 20 crores to 100 crores will be medium. So micro, small and medium. So here you can see what was the previous criteria, and the new criteria is detailed out. So the loans which have been provided for collateral free loans for MSMEs in the Atmanirbhar Bharat Yojana, that is mentioned. and this is the definition tweak. So what is the original, micro, small and medium, and the new turnover criteria? So investment limits and turnover criteria both have been changed. So you can see, so micro enterprises, earlier it was 25 lakh, now it has become 1 crore. So investment limit of 1 crore, up to 1 crore will be micro. For up to 5 crore was for small, now it is up to 10 crores for small. Medium was up to 10 crores, now it has become investment limit up to 20 crores. They are called medium. Turnover criteria has also increased. Turnover criteria for micro is up to 5 crores. And small 50 crores, medium 100 crores. Also, you should know that earlier there were separate criteria for manufacturing and services sector, but now there will be composite criteria for both manufacturing and services. So this you can see micro 1, 10, 20 as investment, how much it's been invested, and turnover is returns which are coming. Not turnover includes entire return which is coming, not just the profit. So that is given. So that is it. Thank you.
Amma, what were you?